name is James Bliss and welcome to this very brief video on a question that we are often asked here at Codestone, and that's what is the difference between the SAP Business One and SAP Business ByDesign solutions that we carry. It's probably worthwhile by starting off and explaining a little bit about SAP's ERP portfolio, and that really is made up of three core products: something called S/4HANA, which is SAP's large enterprise product, so that can be deployed on-premise or in the cloud. But the end of the market that we're going to focus on in this video is really the small to medium-sized enterprise. And that's everyone from a handful of users right up to a couple of thousand users. And SAP have two products for that end of the market, something called SAP Business One and SAP Business ByDesign. As you can see on the slide behind me there, SAP Business ByDesign is a cloud solution. Business One can be on-premise or it can be in the cloud. So if we start off by focusing on the Business One system, one of the key benefits that we have voiced to us as to why customers choose Business One over many of its competitors is how flexible the system is, and flexible without the need for bespoke. So a lot of the configuration is done through the front end, and that's everything from creating fields, forms, objects, workflow, to really customize the system to your specific business needs and processes. The other point to mention there, that a lot of that configuration is not only done by us, but it can also be done by super users at the customer's end, obviously with all relevant security permissions, but it means that you can really kind of get hands-on with the product yourself without a deep knowledge of kind of bespoke or coding, which historically may have been the case. The other point to mention, as I alluded to earlier, is Business One can be installed on-premise or in the cloud. In fact, we've got numerous customers who maybe started life as an on-premise implementation, but over time their requirements change, hardware's become out of warranty, and they've then migrated to the cloud. From a functional standpoint, the system is exactly the same wherever it is deployed. It is purely where it is physically located, and obviously the underlying commercials that differ from an on-premise to a cloud implementation. Lastly, and very importantly, SAP Business One is a true global solution. So there's currently 44 localizations and 28 languages available for Business One. And what's important is those localizations are all maintained and developed by SAP. They're not managed by various different partners around the world. What that means is that, A, you've got the might of SAP developing it, but there's a continuity there as well. So SAP are working with these various different countries to make sure that the system is compliant from a legal and tax standpoint as things change over time. Good examples over here in the UK is things like GDPR and also Making Tax Digital, which are rolled out in patches and versions as they're released. If we move on to talking about SAP Business ByDesign, the first point to mention is the deployment method is quite different from Business One to ByDesign. So ByDesign very much revolves around a number of pre-built scenarios that are based around best practice within the system that can then be tailored to that individual business's requirements. What that means is very quick to roll out. You know, we're really talking weeks rather than months to do an end-to-end ERP deployment. And it means we're not reinventing the wheel in any area, so it can give a lot of structure to businesses. It's also a true SaaS solution, or software as a service. And what I mean by that is, particularly from a licensing and commercial standpoint, there is only about 8 or 9 user license types with Business ByDesign. Based on a user's individual role within the business, there's not the concept of kind of modules and add-ons that the customers need to get their head around. That means from a very early start in the process, we can put a very, very predictable total cost of ownership on the system. Lastly, it's hosted by SAP, and what that means is that SAP are one of the leaders in cloud deployments, and they run some of the most secure and compliant data centers in the world. So really, small to medium-sized customers are getting a lot of the advantages of cloud computing that maybe were reserved for large enterprise in the past. I hope you found this video useful. Please don't hesitate to contact us if you're interested in reviewing ERP systems or would like to find out a bit more about which solution really fits your specific needs. Many thanks.